by the Spirit, he went into the wilderness, tempted of Satan 40 days. You know, and then in verse 14 he says, and in the power of the Spirit, here Jesus comes back. Verse 1, he's full of the Spirit. Verse 14, he's power of the Spirit. And then in verse 18, he picks up the scroll and he opens it at Isaiah 16. He said, Spirit of the Lord is now upon me. Now I'm anointed. So he could have just as well said, I am the Christ, because if you say I'm anointed, the word there is Christ. So he stood up and he said in front of everybody, I'm the Christ, because later they say to him, if you are the Christ, say it plainly. He said, I did say it. So if you look, you don't find a place where he said it, except when he stood in the synagogue. And he said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me. So if it would be written in the Hebrew tongue, he would have said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because I am Christ. So he did say to them, I am Christ, in their synagogue. And then when he said that, you know, he said, I'm anointed to preach. So in other words, first to speak, and then, you know, to heal the sick and stuff like that. And then in verse 32, the Bible says, and he went into their synagogue and taught them. And the people said, what word is this? Because he teach with authority. He does not teach like the Pharisees. So what in the beginning? Oh, come on. And the Spirit of the Lord hovered upon the face of the water. And what happened? The word came out and God said. And this word was life. But this life is the light. And this light came to every man that ever came into the world. And the minute you open up, darkness cannot comprehend the light to overtake it. So darkness got to go if I allow the light. And the light then will shine in darkness, and all darkness will have to flee. Then I become a son of God, and how can I say the words of God like it's God saying it? And if I speak, creation has got to listen, because they are created by the Spirit and the Word. So if I am under the Spirit and I speak the Word, everything, that's why mountains must go and trees must move. Okay, so in verse 32, they says, what word is this? And the Bible says, when he left the synagogue, they found demon-possessed people. And he immediately cast out the devils with a word. And they said, what is this that with a word he commands the devils to come out, and they obey him? And then remember, there come a storm, and the disciples is in the storm, and they wake Jesus up and say, do you not fear that we are perishing? And the Bible says Jesus stood up and said, to the waves be still, and to the storm be calm. And then the disciples, what manner of man is this that the winds and the sea obey his word? Come on, what made him different? What did they see in him that made them recognize, but he's different than anybody? The words he spoke. Why? Because he is the word. And the word was in the beginning, and everything was created by him, and everything ever existed. This word is life, and this life is the light. So I receive the word, I receive life, which is light. All darkness must go, and then my word starts having power. And then it's not my blood that rules my life, but the Spirit of God that rules my life. So I'm regenerated. So I can't fall back on that. So it's a bigger thing that we saw in the past. For those one that, amen. No, it's like just bigger. So God says to me, now it's time to start talking to your blood and say, I don't owe my life to blood. It's written, John 1 said, I don't owe my life to blood. But I am born from above, so I got to live by the Spirit and the Word. So I say to my blood, what do I say to my blood? I say, Joel chapter 3, verse 21 says, I will make the blood innocent that I couldn't do before. Where does he say it? After he says, and I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. So if I receive the Spirit in the Word, born again, regenerated, my blood will be then innocent. In other words, it can't carry stuff anymore. So I say, every cancer cell in this body, you die. You come freaking eight. Jij frek en je gaat eet. Because they test my blood. Your whole body, B cell, lymphoma, follicular, it's all over. The blood is, you know. So whose report will you believe? Okay? So I say, Lord, you know, I've got so much taken. God says, there's a bigger thing that you got to say. So I said, oh. Now people say, oh, so that's why you got sick, so that you can tell us this. No. I tell it because I got it from being sick. Because I didn't pray to ask. No, I prayed to get well. And God says, well, I can tell you. Without you asking me, I can tell you something that will help you out of this thing. If you read the Bible, you could have taken it. This hasn't happened because you have taken it. It happened because somewhere an entrance was given or taken or whatever, you know. They say, okay, you were born with this stuff and it comes out every few years, it pops out. But you must understand that you are regenerated. Your blood is now innocent. And you got to speak the words that I say. Not as you are saying what Jesus said. The words that I say. They are spirit and they are life. Just go over to John 8. Okay, now just a scripture to remember. Just look here before we read John 8. A good scripture to take tonight that will help you in everything would always be Romans 8, the whole chapter. I mean, Romans 8 just takes everything together. You know, that everything you want to know is in Romans 8. That is like, I don't know why. But he says, there is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ. Why? Because when you're in Christ, the old has passed away. So you can't be condemned because Adam is gone. You have now the man from heaven, the second man, the last Adam, which is pure in spirit and in word. He is the word that was there in the beginning. So he can't be condemned, so you can't be condemned. There is therefore now no condemnation for them in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, Adam, but after the Spirit, Christ. For the law, okay, he goes on to say what was impossible for the law to do, God made possible. For the law of the Spirit of life, please, which is in Christ Jesus, has made me free from the law of sin and death. By one man sin entered and so death came upon all. But by one man all can now have life. So there's no condemnation if you're in Christ Jesus, for the law of the Spirit of life, which is in him, has made me free from the law of sin and death. Okay. So here's the story of the woman caught in the act of adultery. Remember the story? And the people said, you know, Jesus, the law says, stoner, what do you say? And remember, then Jesus wrote on the ground and they all disappeared. Now let's pick it up in verse 10. Amplified Bible for me. When Jesus raised himself up, he said to her, woman, where are your accusers? Has no man condemned you? Now remember Romans 8, 31 through 34, who can lay a charge against you? She answered, no one, Lord. And Jesus said, I do not condemn you either. Go on your way, and from now on, sin no more. Okay, hey. Jesus said to her, hey, you that's still living in the bloodline of your forefathers, where sin came into the world, I don't condemn you. Go and sin no more. Go and realize you are not in the line that sin. Go, sin no more. Because I've told you now there's no condemnation. Okay, get it maybe tonight, bed. Once more, Jesus. Okay, you mean this is good. Go anyway, verse 12. Once more, Jesus addressed the crowd. So it's the same story. And he said, I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not be walking in the dark, but will have the light, which is life. Are you there? He will have the light, which is life. Okay. So, Leviticus says life is in the blood. But the New Testament say you can't live in the life that's in the blood. Because you've been regenerated, so you've got to take your life from another source. So the words that I speak, they are spirit and life. Not the words that he spoke. The words that you now speak are spirit and they are life. Come, we all know Proverbs 18:21. Death and life is in the power of the tongue. And he that useth it shall eat the fruit thereof. Deuteronomy 30. I bring before you today death and life. Choose life. And then Paul quotes it in Romans chapter 10. He says, the word is near you, in your mouth and in your heart, to speak it. Which word? That word of righteousness, which if one among a thousand is found in a ransom, you know you're righteous, then you speak. And what will happen? Your flesh will be fresher than a child. You will return to the days of your youth. And everything you speak to will become life. Your finances will live. When you sleep, 200 rand notes are going to dance around your bed and say, have you got a place to hide me? Have you got a place to put me in? I'm running around loose. I come from the sinners, and I've been laid up for the just. And, you know, I've just taken my tour. And have you got a place for me? Have you got a safe? Your body becomes alive. Things start changing. Your wrinkles start going away. Just got a letter this week. People said, you know, we've been watching Spirit Word now for 3 months. My husband and myself, our wrinkles started going away. His hair is getting darker. She said, we've done nothing but listen to Spirit Word channel. And we listen to the words of life, and we're just changing. See, in 3 months, we've changed so much. I said, take me. Do it to me too. Total makeover. I mean, you don't have to take it. You can get old and look ugly, full of, you know, stretch marks all over your face. I say no. I want to get younger and stronger and... Struggle all my life to find out what's wrong with me, you know. Been very sick at 4, very sick at 6, very sick at 12. No, very sick, 38, very sick 3 years ago. And now it's here again. And now I say, no, I can't have it again. I mean, doctors say, we're not going to, you know, go around the bush. You are bleeding yourself to death. You have cancer. I say, no. The report says I have cancer. But I don't take the report, so I will not say my cancer. So from the beginning, I never took it as my own, so I don't say my cancer. It's not my cancer. It's the bloomin' devil's cancer. Can't be mine, because if I read the Bible, I'm supposed to have good gifts. But Kobus, why you? I don't know. Why did you get it? I don't know either. What are you going to do with it? I'm going to speak to it. That's all. It's got to get out. Frack in eight. Frack in eight. You fell, hunderkanker geest, frack in eight. Fell devil. Hoender, devil, chicken. Puk, 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 to hell, whatever. I don't know. I wish I knew. And I tell you, come stay with us for a week. This anelicity is not easy. It's not nice when you can't get up, when you can't make yourself coffee, just drop everything because every cell is infected. You go through ups and downs. When you take up a bottle, the bottle falls. And when you want to stand up, you fall. When you want to speak, you change your words because the stuff goes all over. And you know, and you got to say, for the stripes of Jesus. Okay? The Bible says, stripes of Jesus, you are healed. So I make it first person singular and it changes the grammar a little bit, but the power behind it becomes greater. So I say, I are healed. Mm-hmm. So I want to keep it as close to the Bible as possible. So I don't want to change it, so I keep the R there. But I take the U out and I take myself in. So I are healed. So we got to lay hold on eternal life. But we got to speak the words of God as if it's the word of God. I mean, Pastor Tony used me as an example. When people don't come to church, they say, oh, I was a bit fluish. He said, have you seen Prophet Kobus? And you stay at home. So use me. Mm-hmm. Is that okay? Okay, we were, he that followeth me will not be walking in darkness, but he will have the light, which is the life. So, I mean, how many scriptures have we done already tonight out of the New Testament that says life is the spirit, life is the word, life is not the flesh, life is not blood. So I've got to make a decision and speak it over myself. And realize, I thought I was out of Adam. But it's like, you know, I carry Adam here in one of my pockets. And when it's suitable, I pull him out. Hey, right, test my blood. When I want to say stuff, I say, Adam.
Adam, I call you to life.
And I say, damn you. Right, Adam, you can go to bed. Jesus, today we pray, hallelujah, hallelujah. Lord, we ask, glory, glory, glory. And Adam's hitting me in the side. You hypocrite. You hypocrite. You rose me about 7 times today. Now you want to be so holy before God Almighty. How are you going to get victory if you still protect Adam? People say to you all the time, don't say that. You keep on saying it. So you're protecting Adam. You say, Adam, I want you protected, man. Please, Adam, just walk with me. I want to say stuff like I want to say it. It doesn't make you right. It actually makes you wrong. I'm going to do things the way I see fit. Have you ever thought, is that the way Jesus would do it? I mean, that old book, you know, what would Jesus do? Maybe we should read and say, what do we speak? Hebrews 1. Are you preaching a works gospel? No. I'm preaching grace, but I'm talking about faith. Talk about how do you live. Okay, let's do a third parallel again tonight. Are you in Hebrews 1? I think let's go to Hebrews 11 too. Hebrews 11. I read 11 first. We all know it so well. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtained a good report. Ha ha. Through faith, now listen to verse 3, because it's the same as the other verse 3 that we're going to read now. Through faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Where have you read that scripture? Romans 4:17. Remember, God calls things that are not as though they already were. I thought somebody would just say amen. Okay, By faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that things that are seen were not made by things that do appear. God called things that do not exist, although they already exist. That is faith. We all know it, but I hope tonight I'm going to help you by the Spirit and the Word to just be lifted up a little and realize, my goodness, how much of Adam is still running around me? How much of Christ have really taken control? Have the old totally passed away, or do I resurrect it every day by my mouth? Okay, and I'm not talking to you, but you can send the message to your cousin in Singapore. Where? Hebrews chapter 1. I'm reading the Amplified. In separate revelations, each of which set forth a portion of the truth and in different ways, God spoke of old to our forefathers in and by the prophets. But 1 Peter 1 says it was the Spirit of Christ in them. But in the last of these days, He has spoken to us in the person of a Son. Hey, you got to get it. Not just the Son, a Son. So God now speaks through sons. Okay, so do you want to be an Old Testament prophet? That one moment you speak by the Spirit of Christ, and the other moment you fed up with this and you just turn your back on God. You run and hide in a cave. You just killed 800 priests of different cults, and the next minute you run away from a woman. And then you start complaining to God. God, look at me. Why this? Why this happened to me? Why this? You know? 3 years ago, and this, I've never asked once why. God, why did this happen to me? You know? I'm just trying my best. I'm going to get out of this. I don't want this thing. It's not mine. I'm not going to inherit it. I'm not going to sign for it. I'm not going to say it's the report. I don't believe that report. And I said last week, you know, that's the difference between facts and truth. The fact is, this bottle has still got water in it. The truth is, I can throw the water out and it'll have no water in it. So I can't say that water, I must say that bottle with water. It's a fact there's water in it. The truth is, I can throw the water out and it'll have no water in it. The fact is, the doctor says you have sugar diabetes. The truth is, the word of God says you are healed. So I've got to make that decision, okay? Whom He appointed heir and lawful owner of all things, also by and through whom He created the worlds. Do you see it's the same as Hebrews 11, 1? Somebody? Somebody, anybody? By the Son, He created the worlds. By the Word, He created the worlds. But the Son is the Word. And this Word was made flesh and dwelt amongst us. And this Word is life, and the life is the light. Okay. For those who were not here, I preached many times, a long time ago in the tent and then in our old church, and I just touched on it in the new church, where, you know, it's been proven, people struggle, you know, to receive it, but blood and light is exactly the same thing, just a different form. Like when you cool water down, you get ice. When you heat water up, you get vapor. When you take blood and you can get it condensed, congealed, blood is a congealed form of light because it's got all the same substances. So if I can get blood to a certain point, it'll disappear and it'll become light. Who knows, you take blood plasma, you spin it in, they put it in a bottle and they spin it. We've just been to clinics in Germany. They spin it and the red disappears and it becomes white like water. And they inject you with that stuff and it does something to your immune system. Okay? So if they speed it up fast enough and they made this thing that they do like put on cancer patients, they spin it so fast till it becomes light and it does the same as a beam of, what is it, laser beam. And your own blood spins around you and it becomes the laser that kills the cancer cells in your body. It shows that light is the higher form of something that is called blood. So this is, okay, what I'm going to say now is my theory. I don't know if I've heard anybody say that, but this is what I believe, but till I get the scriptures, I will not preach it as gospel. But I think, like Paul says, I have the Spirit and I'm right. When Adam partook of the wrong tree, something happened to his blood. Because by one man sin entered, and by sin death upon all. So I will cleanse your blood that was not cleansed before. So if I receive the life, which is the light, my blood must change. I can't sit with cancer. I can't sit with sugar diabetes. I can't sit with sicknesses. I must get into, hey, the Spirit in me now takes control of the man, which is called Kobus. So let your Spirit rise up in me. Spirit, you take control. Speak to the body. Body, I'm now speaking from my Spirit. You are the temple of the Holy Ghost. Cancer is not welcome here. Get out, stay out, every cancer cell die. I speak to this body and I say, I are healed. Till we get it, we're going to do something with it. In other words, I must be anointed. I must live in the Spirit. Remember when Jesus came out of the tomb on the third day and he appeared unto the disciples? And you know, they're all shocked. And Jesus said, come and touch me. A ghost. I know the Bible says spirit, but it's the same as where they said a ghost. Has not flesh and bone. Come touch me. I'm flesh and bone. Why doesn't Jesus refer to blood? Because he didn't owe his birth to blood. He was born from above. So he never referred to his blood, but that it's the redeeming power to cleanse your blood and get you out of all your trouble. Where you can be the anointed one and say the words of God. Ephesians 5. It's actually a small message. I'm just building around it so that you can get the full meaning of it and understand, where's my life? Is it in Leviticus 17 in the blood, or is it in the Spirit and the Word? John, I got to decide. Check my tongue. Because my tongue is the one that declares, where am I living? And it will tell the people around you where you are living. The world will see it. People take note. You must hear that man talk, man. People take note. It's quiet now. What I'm going to say now is not going to change the situation. So why must I say wrong stuff? The situation will not change. So I'd rather try and work the situation out when the time comes and do it in a proper way. And I'm not going to lower myself to a position where I speak the wrong language. Okay,